Welcome or welcome back, beautiful souls, to the channel. I'm Shika, your conscious mentor, and today's video is going to be on how to get over a breakup with shadow work. I've been getting a lot of questions from you guys, especially during this time as the world is shifting, where you are either going through a divorce, a breakup, during the time of us staying home. Let me know down below if this is you, or perhaps just going through this maybe shift of a relationship that has been disconnected. I know breaking up is not easy, and I really want to share with you guys the power of shadow work and how to really maneuver through shadow work to help you heal and go deeper. So I'm really excited to go over these really great tips, tools, and techniques, journal prompts that you can do to help you get over a breakup with shadow work. So before we get into the video, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, like, and subscribe, as well as put notification bells. I do 3 or more videos every single week for you amazing, beautiful souls. And if you feel like going deeper, diving deeper into your work, I actually just released an 8-week mentoring program called the Conscious Shadow Rebirth. If you feel that you're ready to go deeper into your healing and get to the root of the things that you're going through and have a conscious experience through your spiritual journey, you can go down below and sign up for the Conscious Shadow Rebirth mentoring program. So excited for that. And today's subscriber of the day is Tori. Thank you so much for being part of this family. I'm so grateful for each and every single one of you and to be part of your big spiritual shifts. Let's get into this video. So make sure you grab some tea, some snacks, because we're really going to go deep into how to shift throughout a breakup, how to shift our energy, how to heal. I know right now, depending on what stage you are in, and let me know down below in the comments section, you might feel this sense of like confusion. You might feel this sense of like, I'm just ready, I'm happy, or maybe it was completely mutual between the two parties. Whatever it is, this is one of the most important times, and I really don't want you to rush this whole healing. I really don't want you to rush everything that is emotionally just shifting right now. So the first thing on how to get over a breakup with shadow work is why the universe disconnected this connection. The explanation of having a relationship, whether it's platonic or intimate, is really that two beings are connecting their heart chakra, their sacral chakra, and their third eye. They're connecting their auras, their energies together. And when you decide to break up with someone or you both break up, it is going to adjust to not feel that energetic pull that you both have, using that sense of like you both had a space in each other's heart, right? So it is a huge growth opportunity for you. This is an opportunity where you can ask yourself that the first reason why this disconnection was, you know, released out of your life is some relationships are meant to teach you something for the person that you are meant to be with. And it wasn't until I got into that experience when I was going through my breakup and healing and doing my shadow work, I noticed, wow, this whole experience was meant to help me. So then when I found my soulmate, I was ready and I have released and healed what I needed to. So I want you to ask yourself, what are the things that you've grown from this relationship? Like whether it's the good times, the not so great times, the in between, what are some opportunities that were growth opportunities for you? Or how are you meant to grow before you are meant to be with someone? And, you know, I see it time and time again, like I said, when you go through a spiritual awakening, sometimes your partner is not going to grow with you. Sometimes they're not aligned with you, and that is okay. But it is definitely a growth. Every relationship is a growth opportunity. The other thing is unaligned energy. You know, again, like I said, sometimes if you're going through your own growth and the person is not, that's going to create the stagnant energy. If the person is toxic or maybe narcissistic or have these other tendencies from their body pains, as we talk about quite often, body pain is defined as any energy that is not love energy. It is anger, it is sadness, it is all those things that we hold into our body, right? And when we react, especially at a young child, we react with this pain and it creates this emotional kind of effect on our aura and our being. So sometimes when we're in a relationship, that's why we find people who, you know, stay away from each other, or like they fall out of love, or maybe sometimes that they feel that they are not meant to be together, or perhaps that they're both just constantly clashing. It's because there is an unalignment in each other's, you know, aura and energy fields, and that energy is being blocked by something that is not communicated, something that is not shifted, something that is not aligned, or something that is just not meant for you at this time. And that is okay. Again, I'm gonna be that mentor for you, but I'm also gonna be that friend to say that is okay. Like whatever you are feeling right now with the unalignment is gonna help you grow once, and again, it's going to help you grow. The other part of why the universe disconnected you two is manipulation and abuse. I've seen this a lot with a lot of relationships where they come out of a relationship, I've been there, and then I find out that this whole relationship, I was being emotionally manipulated. And what shadow work does is it teaches us that our own mirrors and our own being of who we are when we look at ourselves in the mirror is actually reflected and similar in the person that we are connected with. With law of attraction, we attract what we are. And does it mean that you are that person who is narcissistic and abusive or whatever it is, but you could be the person that they like to lean on because that's what makes them feel comfortable. Or maybe that you personally have not healed that wound yet and that's what makes you feel comfortable in a way as well. Sometimes we get comfortable with our own pains, and I find that after a breakup, this is really a vulnerable and learning experience where we can kind of be with our pains and understand more about this disconnection even further. So the second thing on how to get over a breakup with shadow work, and I've seen this a lot with my mentors, and let me know because I've been there. I'm gonna put a star emoji down below because I know you have as well, but put a star emoji if you've ever had the temptation after a breakup or even currently right now where you just want company. And that is normal. You know, you have emotionally connected yourself with this person, and having a breakup, you are disconnecting, and there are parts of you that maybe you have been emotionally dependent on them, and they've been emotionally dependent on each other, and that's going to take some time to adjust. So how to avoid temptation of wanting company and working on yourself is very important, and that all comes from community. So one of the biggest things I would really encourage you to do during this time of shadow work, while you're really processing the emotions and disconnecting that energy cord, is working on community. So whether it's a soul family you already have, or someone that can help and support you, someone that is willing to listen to you, someone who can be supportive, you know, and I don't want to say supportive of telling you what to do, because sometimes most people don't need that. Most people just need that extra ear to be like, I went through a breakup, this is how I feel, I'm angry, I'm sad, I'm whatever. And start with a sentence when you explain to someone what you're going with I feel. This is something that I always share with all of my mentors, is I feel. When you start with I feel, as opposed to this is what happened and this is whatever, you can come and speak from the heart and try to hold eye connection when you're going through this, because it's really going to allow you to connect with that soul space. It is vulnerable, obviously, but that small little switch of, like, instead of thinking of what you want to say or telling them the story, tell them the story from your emotions. And that's going to help you feel so much more released. It is so therapeutic. It is such a great way to deepen that shadow work, and it's a great shadow work technique. The other thing is respecting each other's boundaries. So another thing too is this is the time of vulnerability. So when we are in that emotional vulnerability, we might be tempted to go back to that person. So this is why community is so important. When you get those temptations, go to that friend, go to that soul family, you know, call them up, chat with them, and don't feel guilty to reach out, because I know I had a hard time with always feeling guilty that I was reaching out to someone for help, because this is a time that I need to lean on someone, and that is okay. I have a card actually in my deck that reminds me of this, and I'm gonna see if it comes to me, but it's not a bad thing to lean on someone. Like, I think we have this connotation that we're still working through as a society, as a collective, that if we ask someone for help, we are weak. Take out that mindset. You are not weak. And if you are weak right now, that is okay. But you are not weak. You are releasing. You're releasing what you have to at this time. And that is fine. I can't find the card, but it's a bear card that comes through. And I think it's really important for us to understand that we have to allow ourselves to ask for a leg up when we need it the most. Another thing is, can help you mature your shifts as well. So I find having new energy, new perspectives, new people that can just listen, even if they don't say anything, can really be therapeutic and healing for you. And again, having a really great person that can help you and support you throughout this time. I know a lot of you guys have been saying this YouTube channel has been that soul family. If it is, that's amazing, and I'm so happy to be part of that. And all of you guys, all of the subscribers here that's to be part of it, I see you guys commenting, I see you guys cheering each other on. It is so important. So if you have that, it's going to help you with that temptation of going back to the old, going back to that old toxic energy, going back to the unaligned energy, going back to the unaligned relationship, which is why this breakup occurred. Nothing is a mistake. Everything happens for a reason. And you really have to take this time to process what this reasoning was for you, not for anyone else, for you, to hone into your growth, to hone into your overall soul growth as a person. Because this is what this relationship is teaching you. It's teaching you your soul growth and soul lessons, which we'll go into even deeper later on. The third way to get over a breakup with shadow work is in allowing yourself to call in your guides. Calling in your guides is going to be very helpful for you to shift during this time. And again, like I said, you need maximum support. You need to be felt like you're being loved, you're being healed, you're being supported. Really allowing yourself to have all the support systems that you need. And I remember specifically when I went through my toxic relationship breakup, I kept seeing the 111s everywhere. I was seeing the ones everywhere, the angel numbers. And if you have been seeing angel numbers, I'm gonna link the playlist and some angel numbers down below so you guys can check it out. I have over like 100 videos on angel numbers to help you guys out. So most likely I've done a video for you. But this is really an opportunity for you to listen to the synchronicities, the numbers, the signs, the support, to ask them and call them in during meditation. Guys, can you come with me? I need support right now as I get over this person. If you feel this loneliness, hey guys, I need support and just your energy to help me give support so I'm not feeling that I want company out of my sense of vulnerability. Help me in this time. Again, when we can surrender to humility and just being with ourselves and being honest with ourselves, we are actually healing. We're really getting to the root of the pains that we're going through as we grieve this relationship. And this is important. So as for company, allowing yourself to be understood by releasing the energy and calling in your guides, they're going to be great. I've seen so many people who've gone through big changes and awakenings like a breakup, and their guides end up coming through, and that's when they have the strongest connections with them, because this relationship is a growth opportunity and they know at this pivotal time that they're gonna grow and maybe change as a person the way that they're meant to in this lifetime. So it's so beautiful to see every single time. So the fourth way of how to get over a breakup with shadow work is really focusing on this journal prompt. And I think this really helped me with my healing. It's one of the journal prompts that I give my mentors a lot. So I wanted to share this with you guys. How was my energy shifting? You know, so during the time of the relationship, when I'm understanding the temptations and I'm going through all the experiences, when I'm connecting with my shadow self throughout that part, how was my energy changing at this time leading up to the breakup? How was their energy changing this time? And just be vulnerable with that. Be raw with that energy. Now, how were you changing at this time right now? Like, what are some values that have changed for you during the time? You know, it could be the openness of your relationship. It could be the growth personally, like you both are growing differently or not growing at all. It could be the inability to be emotionally supported, physically supported, you know, mentally supported. If any of those things come through, or even guilt, shame, manipulation, if there's a part of you that feels this, ask yourself that. So I want you to sit with yourself in silence, no meditation music, so powerful. Take a deep breath in through the nose and exhale sounding out through the mouth. And when you do that, I want you to ask yourself, how is my energy changing and how has my energy changed? And the second question is, what are my values and how have my values changed? How have our values changed differently in the two spaces? And imagining you both as you visualize, if you want to hold the space of visualization and meditation, as you visualize, or even just feeling the energy of their energy presence as you ask those questions and yours. Having that contrast is going to make you help you process the breakup more, help you heal from the breakup, and just let whatever comes through. Crying, laughing, happiness, sadness, anger, whatever it is, releasing it out of the body, because we want to release that body pain so you can really allow yourself to grow throughout this breakup and grow throughout these emotions. The fifth and simplest way, and I know a lot of people talk about this, but I'm going to reiterate it with it because this is so important. I remember times that I would literally go through a whole notebook going through this specific thing, and it is daily meditation and journaling my emotions. I would start with the sentence of I feel and write down as much, and sometimes I would only get through four sentences, and there are some days that I would write four pages long. But this is really an opportunity for you to let go of any of the sadness, the anger, the grief, the understanding, just allowing yourself to understand your emotions. And now I'm going to add another part to this. I want you, whenever you feel like those emotions come up, to go through your journal and to look at your journal entries and actually go and read them. Because a lot of people just say journal, but what do you do with them after? I actually read my journal sometimes, you know, after the breakup, or perhaps like when there's something that comes up that triggers me, I go back and I say, oh wow, this is where this energy is the same, you know, this is where I was also feeling that. Why was I feeling that? Oh, I wrote that day that we had a breakup, or that argument that we broke up, I felt so like emotionless, so like powerless. And that's what allowed me to want to break up in the first place. They felt like they took my power. It felt like I couldn't speak my truth. So when we're able to journal and daily meditation, it is an opportunity for you to actually track your emotions. And I actually encourage it for people to do that, especially when we're going through an awakening such as a breakup. So this is a very amazing journal thing that you can do, you know, journaling your emotions after your meditation with breath work, going into nature to really stick with yourself and ground yourself during this time of shifting, because you are going to feel ungrounded, and that is okay. I actually have a root chakra meditation that I will link here for you. It's a healing. So I send you Reiki energy healing during this time. So if you feel like you're a little bit ungrounded, I got you. I'm going to send you that loving energy. Morning meditations is important, because these are the little times that we've noticed the person's not there. You know, it's us waking up and not seeing them. It's us not being able to say good morning. It's us not having breakfast. It's the little things that make it hard for us to want that company again and come back to those old toxic energies. So this is an opportunity for you to create something new, such as a new meditation. Create discipline in your morning, discipline in your first hour of your morning, to allow you to really focus on, how am I growing from this relationship breakup? How am I releasing? How is this teaching me about my soul lessons in this lifetime? How is it teaching me about how I'm growing as a being? It is more than just a breakup. It is an opportunity for you to learn how to be better in relationships in general. That's literally what our breakups are for. It is teaching us the unaligned emotions that are not meant at this time, is how are we supposed to be growing on our own independently in order for us to attract the right relationships that are meant for us and our soul in this lifetime. Literally, that is the purpose of breakups. So I think a lot of people don't know that, and I just want to be there to share this with you, because if I did know that at that time of going through these breakups and going back to those relationships and leaving, coming back, I would have been much stronger. I would have been, you know, much grown. But at the same time, everything happens for a reason. Like, you're meant at this point of your relationship, or this point of your healing process of your breakup, to help you with your shadow work, to help you with your soul again, like I said. The sixth and final thing on how to get over a breakup during this time with shadow work is really to choose one new thing. So I want you to type down below one new thing that you've always wanted to do, one new thing that you've always wanted to take in. I remember during my breakup, I went back to dancing. I used to dance competitively, if you guys don't know, for over like 15 years. And I decided, you know what? I'm gonna go back to dancing. I really miss it. It makes me happy. It makes me smile. So why not dance again? So I got back into it. I loved it. And it was just an opportunity for me to just fully move my energy, not only like connect with my feminine divine energy. And this is a little clue, a little tip for you. Anything that is creative, like anything that activates your creative feminine energy, is going to be amazing, because a lot of our emotions are stored into our stomach. So anything like art, drawing, dancing, planting, anything that allows you to create or make something is a great thing to do as a new thing to take up. So let me know in the comment section what that new thing that your body's been thriving to do, or maybe you've always thought of doing it, maybe you've been nervous to. This is a great opportunity to do that, to allow you to get that healing, nurturing feminine energy that you need. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video on how to get over a breakup during this time with shadow work, and it is going to help you so much. Know that this whole relationship experience is something that was meant for you in this lifetime. And it is meant for you to go deeper. It is meant for you to be better in your relationship. It is meant for you to be your true, authentic, higher conscious self. And sometimes we need to be told that to allow us to kind of be like, oh yeah, I remember. Now I understand why this is happening, even in the points of grief and pain. So I hope this video motivated you. I hope you are excited to apply all these 6 things. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, and subscribe, as well as put notification bells. I do 3 or more videos every single week for your amazing souls. If you feel called to go even deeper into your healing, you can sign up for the Conscious Shadow Rebirth Mentoring Program down below. I'll leave it down there for you. And let me know how you're feeling. I am here to support you, and I love you so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.